fucking name, huh?
Like a soldier, I keep on moving forward. Always getting closer. Marching till it's over.
Hello, friends and allies, and welcome to today's video. Today we will be charm hunting without rapid respawn, and I will show some unique and good spawns to be going to get both some quick charms but also slow charms. But I think each area is one of the best to get a certain creature, so let's start. So, to my surprise, I thought we were only going to be able to make Stampborn during rapid respawn. But I tried it out without having any rapid, and it worked out great. Here, you're gonna gain 25 charm points for around 1.5 hours of work. And while you're here, don't forget to change the value of the stamper items which you will be looting here. So, pick them up and make some easy profit while you're charm hunting. For our next spawn, we're gonna go to Venor. Here, the focus is gonna be the Emerald Flyer and the Marsh Stalkers. The Salamanders will just be a bonus, and the Swampling will you be making in Port Hope Laboratory anyways. So, simply just focus, as I said, the Emerald and the Marsh Stalkers, and you will gain 30 charm points in the work of 50 minutes, with the Salamander being the bonus. The focus of this hunt is gonna be to the north, because here you're gonna be the most salamanders, because those are the creatures which you will not be finishing. The other monster will just simply be killing on the way anyways and finish first. Salamander, we will be finding out a better area in the future, I believe. Have you guys heard about the iceberg mini wall change in the Shakoyas in Port Hope? Anyways, just head to the world board in the Adventure Guild and you can read the following. A big iceberg has been washed up at the coast of North Porto. It seems to be inhibited by strange white fireballs. And here we will be charm hunting, because here you will finish the Shakoyas the most even. It will take the work of 45 minutes to gain 45 charm points, and this is only active during the mini world change. For the pathing in this area, you're gonna be running to the top of the mountain and also to the bottom of it and clear it all out. You do not actually need rapid respawn for this area, even though it's rather small. The respawn was fairly quick, and 45 minutes is a good amount of time. For our next area, you're gonna need access to the island Tirsung, which only takes a couple of minutes to do with the Barbarian test and a little bit more. Here, you will be charm hunting the Frost Giants, and you will be here for 50 minutes to gain 30 charm points. For the pathing of this area, I recommend to be downstairs the most in the cave and not at the top of the area. I think it was more monsters downstairs. The next spawn is generally the favorite hunt of low levels, the Ravenous Lava Lurkers, but we're gonna be here at level 700 and we simply just gonna make them. It's gonna be the work of 1.5 hours to make 25 charm points, and for the pathing, it's simply gonna be the traditional pathing of going in circles. And for my level, the issue was that I was out killing it a little bit, so this could actually be done during rapid, but I think I wanted the charms right now, so I did it anyways. And the amount of charm you gain for the work of 1.5 hours is decent. Welcome to the Knights of Faerist. Here you will be facing a lot of monsters, but I decided to categorize them like this. And here you're gonna focus primarily the boogies, because the Dark Faunas and Twisted Pokas can be done downstairs. So the focus is actually just the Bogus and the Swan Maiden, and the other creatures will be possible to do during the day. So here, to finish the Bogus will take around 5 hours, but I highly recommend that you take a look downstairs at the Dark Faun, the Twisted Pokas and the Bogus to see how you should combine them in a good way. I think when you have done around 600 boogies, you are ready to go downstairs. So I think you should be around 3 hours on the surface and then go downstairs to combine the fairies during the night. So for the pathing here, you're simply gonna be on the surface of fairest, and don't forget to put on a dwarven ring. And now we're in fairest during the day, and you have 30 minutes on you to kill them as fast as you can. So for the work of 4 hours, we're gonna gain 50 charm points from the fawn and on the pocus. And the bonus of the Swan Maiden, Pixie and Niv will be retrieved with 75 points as well, by combining the day and the evenings. By charming for around 8 hours, you will gain 200 points. So it's not the most efficient one, but it's definitely a charm nice doing in this area. The next areas is the Were-Hyenas, where you will gain 50 charm points in the work for around a little bit more than 2 hours. And I highly recommend that you focus the shamans more than the other creatures, because they are going to be the slowest to be hunting. And this is a really large area, and it will be even more profit if you were going during the time of the dropping of moonlight crystals, which is during the time of Feroxa. Just to add some extra money to the profit in this area. And don't forget to do the Shadow Thorn. Ask a guide NPC for Thorn Firewall Change, and they will say if it's active or not. Just bring a prepared bucket, and here you'll gain easy 100 charm points, which I also made a video on. Anyways, I hope I gave you some tips for further charm hunting. Happy hunting, and I will see you guys in the next video.